Hello children, welcome back to the topic data handling. Today we are going to solve the sums of exercise 5.2. See the first question, exercise 5.2 first question. A survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people liked in a city. Adjoining pie chart shows the finding. Here a pie chart is given which shows C. Light music is liked by 40%. Second, semi-classical music is liked by 20%. Classical music is liked by 10%. And folk music is liked by 30%. This is the question given. Now, see the first question. If 20 people were liked, 20 people liked classical music, how many young people were surveyed? See, what is the percentage given? Classical music is liked by 10%. So we know that for 10 people, what is the meaning of 10%? For 10 people, 100 people are surveyed, then 10 people liked classical music. So for 10, number of people surveyed equal to 100. So we have to find for 20 people, how many people should be surveyed. So for 20, number of people surveyed equal to, how will you get 400, for 10, 100. So for 1, how much? 100 divided by 10. And then to get 20, we have to multiply it by 20. Or you can do this by taking direct proportion also. For 10, 100. So for 20, how much? So 100 multiplied by the ratio is 20 upon 10. Both the way you can do. So the answer after calculating you will get 200. So 200 people are surveyed. Now move on to second question. Which type of music is liked by maximum number of people? We can see from the diagram. See 40% is the highest number. Other all numbers are less than 20, 10, 30 are less than. So 40% is the highest number, so it is for light music. So we can say the answer, light music is liked by maximum number of people. Third question, if a cassette company were to make 1000 CDs, then how many each type would they make? That is, total 1000 CDs should be made. So each type of music, how many CDs should be made? That is, according to the proportion of the like of the people, we have to make the CD. So total number of CD is equal to 1000. Now number of CDs of classical music. Classical music is liked by 10% of people. So number of CDs of classical music equal to 10% of 1000. So 10, what is the meaning of 10%? 10 upon 100, you have to multiply by 1000. Then you will get 100. So classical music, how many CDs are to be made? 100. Similarly, we can calculate for all type of music. Second, number of CDs of semi-classical music. How many people are liked by semi-classical music? 20%. So 20% of 1000 equal to 20 upon 100 multiplied by 1000. So it's equal to 200. So 200 CDs of semi-classical music should be made. Third is number of CDs of light music. Light music is liked by 40% of people. So 40% of 1000 equal to 40 upon 100 multiplied by 1000 equal to 400. Third one, last one, number of CDs of folk music. Folk music is liked by 30%. So 30% of 1000 equal to 30 upon 100 multiplied by 1000 equal to 300. So you can say classical music is liked by 100 CDs, semi-classical music, 200 CDs, light music, 400 CDs, and folk music, 300 CDs should be made. By adding, we should get 1,300 plus 400 plus 200 plus 100. You will get 1,000. So our answer is correct. Now we'll go to second question. A group of 360 people were asked to vote for their favorite season from the three seasons, rainy, winter and summer. This table is given in the question. This is question only. See, summer season, number of people voted 90. Rainy season, 120 people are liked. And winter season, 150 people are liked. This is the question. Now we have to write the answer of these questions given below. First question, which season got the most vote? Which season is highest number? 150. For which season? Winter. So the answer is winter season got the most vote. Second question, find the central angle of each of the sector. We have to find the central angle for each. So we have made the table as I have taught in the previous video. We are going to make the table with the four columns. First season, second column, number of votes. So first two columns are the question only. Third column is infraction and fourth column central angle. So first summer, 90. So what is the fraction? Now we have to find the total of all this. So first summer 90, rainy season 120 and winter 150. We are added, the total is 360. Now we have to find the fraction. So summer, how will you find the fraction? 90 upon total 360, simplifying 1 by 4. Second one, rainy, now angle, central angle, the fraction you have to multiply by 360. So 1 by 4 multiplied by 360 equal to 90 degrees the central angle. Second one, 120, so fraction is 120 upon total 360, so it's equal to 1 by 3. So central angle equal to 1 by 3 multiplied by 360 equal to 120. Third one, winter 150, so fraction is 150 upon total 360, simplifying you'll get 5 by 12. Now central angle equal to 5 by 12 multiplied by 360, then you will get 150 degree. Third question is, draw a pie chart to show this information. As I had explained yesterday, today we are going to draw again. First, for drawing pie chart, we have to draw a circle of any convenient radius. Any radius, we can draw a circle. And draw one radius. Anywhere, we can draw one radius. I have drawn the radius here. Now, what is the first one, summer, what is the central angle corresponding to that? 90 degree. So we are going to keep the protractor on this radius we have drawn. I have shown here, we are drawn. Here is the radius we have drawn and I have kept the protractor here. And how much we have to measure? 90 degree. And here is the point of 90 degree. And I have put a dot here. Then after taking that, see, we have to draw the radius. I just turned the picture. We have to draw the radius. So what you will get? 90 degrees the angle. And it is for which season? Summer. I have written on the side. So 90 degree we have drawn. Now how will you find the next one? What is the next one? Rainy season 120 degree. So we have to mark 120 degree. For that, what we have to do? Keep the protractor on the new radius we have drawn. New radius, see, I have shown here. We have to keep the protractor on new radius and measure angle 120 degree. Then you will get here, see, like this picture. Here we kept the protractor and measured the angle 120. So you'll get the point here joining the radius. New radius is this one. So 120 degree we measured here, which is for which season? Rainy season, I have written here. Then the remaining will be for remaining, automatically it will come 150 degree for winter. So we have drawn all the three and you can color it if you want. Otherwise, we can shade it with the different markings. So I have marked different shade for different season. So our pie chart is ready. I will go to third question. Draw a pie chart showing the following information. The table shows colors preferred by a group of people. This is question. Blue color is liked by 18 people, green color for 9 people, red color is liked by 6 people, and yellow by 3 people. And total is also given in the question. Total number of people equal to 36. So for drawing pie chart, first of all, we have to make the table for central angle. So colors, number of people, infraction and central angle. So blue 18, green 9, red 6, yellow 3. This is given. And the total we also given 36. Now we will find fraction of each. Blue color, how will you get the fraction? What is the number of blue color? 18 upon total is 36. So 18 upon 36 equal to 1 by 2. Now central angle equal to the fraction you have to multiply by 360. So 1 by 2 multiplied by 360 equal to 180. Second, green 9. So fraction 9 upon total 36 equal to 1 by 4. So central angle equal to 1 by 4 multiplied by 360 equal to 90. Third, red color is liked by 6. So fraction equal to 6 upon total 36. So 1 by 6. Now central angle equal to 1 by 6 multiplied by 360 equal to 60 degree. And the last one, yellow, 3. So 3 upon 36 equal to 1 by 12. So central angle equal to 1 by 12 multiplied by 360 equal to 30. Now we have made the table. Now we have to draw the pie chart. So as I told in the previous question, first of all we have to draw a circle of any radius. Then we have drawn one radius here. Now what is the first one angle? First blue is liked by 18 people and its central angle is 180 degree. So first of all we have to make 180 degree. So keeping the protractor here, we have to make the second radius which is corresponding to 180 degree. So 180 degree is marked here. Then after that we have to mark the second one. What is second color? Second color green. Green 90 degree. So for green 90 degree we have to mark. So we have to keep the protractor on the new radius and we have to find the 90 degree line here will come. So marking it will get like this. So first this part is corresponding to 180 degree blue color, and second here we kept and here 90 degree new radius we have drawn here and it is corresponding to 90 degree, that is green. Then similarly, again, we have to keep the protractor on the new radius and measure angle how much? 60 degree. See this diagram here, 60 degree radius will draw. So that is corresponding to red color and the remaining will be 30 degree for yellow color. So I have shaded different designs. So this 180 degree corresponding to blue color and 90 degree corresponding to green color, 60 degree corresponding to red color and 30 degree corresponding to yellow color. Like this, we have done the pie chart. I think you might have got the idea how to draw the pie chart now. The remaining questions we will solve tomorrow. Thank you.